Hello and welcome to a quick tutorial on how to use a recycle bin with Unraid. When you first set up Unraid and create a network share that you want to access with your PC, you might notice that when you accidentally delete a file, it is not easily recoverable. So if I delete this important document, it is gone and there is no easy way for me to get it again. And if we open the recycling bin, there is also nothing in there. However, if you delete a file on your desktop, or pretty much anywhere on your C drive, it goes straight into the recycle bin and can easily be restored by right-click restore or just drag and dropping it back to where it belongs. Unraid does offer a way to activate a recycling bin to prevent you from accidentally losing data, and I have set this up with the share called Media with Trash. If I go into here and delete this important document once again, and then refresh the folder, I will see that there is a new folder called .recycle.bin, and inside there is my recently deleted file. I can just take it right back out again if I accidentally deleted it. This recycle bin also mimics the folder structure of the file that is deleted, so if I go into folder 1, and then folder 1_2, and delete this another important document, and then go back to the main part of the share, go into recycle bin, there is now a folder 1, then inside only the folder 1_2, not the _1 or _3, because we didn't delete anything out of those folders, and if I go into here, there is my document. I can just take it right back out again. If this sounds interesting to you, then let's look at how to implement it in Unraid. To enable the recycling bin, we will have to install the associated plugin. To do that, we head over to Apps. And if this is the first time we install a plugin, it will ask us to install the Community Application plugin. This plugin will enable a sort of app store that we can use to install many other apps. So I press install, then when it's done, I press done, I accept the disclaimer, and I accept the plugin note. And now we have access to the Unraid App Store. Here we want to search for the recycling bin, and then press install. Once it's done, we press done. And we can now access its settings via Actions and then Settings, or we can go over to Plugins and press the Trashbin logo, or we can even go to Settings and then press the Trashbin logo. So a lot of ways to open its settings. In the settings page, I will only go through the options briefly. If you do have any specific questions, feel free to ask down below. So, first option, if you have it enabled to yes, the plugin will start with the start of your server as well. Update recycle bin size and background. I personally set this to no because it caused quite a high amount of CPU usage. But yeah, you can try it out yourself. You can enable it on unassigned devices or not. You can add some specific advanced parameters. You can set which type of permissions the files in your recycling bin should have. You can exclude certain files or directories or shares, like I did with my Media Without Trash to show you. You can set a amount of days before a file will be considered aged. And then you can automatically remove aged files on a schedule. You can have a notification for aged files, and you can log deleted files. Once you've set everything up how you want it, you can then press the start button to initially start the plugin for the first time. And on the next boot of your server, it will automatically start again due to this setting. If you have the update recycle bin size and background set to yes, then you will always see the correct amount of files in there and also always know how many are aged and you can delete. But if not, you might have to press the refresh button when you want to get a current update on the amount of deleted files. In my case, I can see I have one share that has something in its trash, and I can click on the browse button to then see, oh, here in the share media with trash, there is one file in there, the important documents copy.txt, that was deleted and put there. I can also delete a whole share if I'm sure that there's nothing in the recycling bin that I still need. I can empty the full trash up here, or I can just remove the aged files that are older than these amount of days since they were put into the trash. If you have set lock deleted files to yes, then you will see every single deleted file down here in a big list. And that concludes the quick tutorial on how to enable a recycling bin in Unraid Shares. I hope you learned something, and see you around next time.